Managed Instance is a resource that is deployed inside your subnet. Sometimes it might be required to move this instance from one subnet to another or to another VNET. Let's learn how to do this. During instance creation, you have to specify the virtual network and subnet where you want to have your managed instance deployed. This is located on networking tab at the very top of this page. When you open this dropdown, you will see a lot of options for deployment. You can create new virtual network, which means that as part of the instance deployment, you will also get virtual network and subnet created and properly configured for managed instance deployment. Besides this, you can choose some of the existing subnets, and there are some prerequisites that must be satisfied in order for subnets to be used for instance deployments. First, we can notify three groups of subnets. One that is capable for the feature wave November 2022, a brand new release for SQL Managed Instance. Then subnets can be part of the group that is without feature wave, which means that if you deploy in this subnet, you will not have new capabilities available. And then we have subnets that are not ready for instance deployment and they are disabled. You can check why they're disabled by hovering the info box on the right side of them. So you have created your instance, you've been running it for some time, and now for any reason you want to change your subnet where instance is deployed. Let's imagine this is the instance you want to move. On the left side, you will find the networking tab. And on this tab, you will see the same component that exists during instance creation. However, what is different is that a smaller number of subnets is available for subnet move. And why is this the case? This is because in order to move your instance to another subnet, you have to do some of the tasks that on instance creation are done on your behalf. And in order to distinct the status of the subnet and if it can be used for instance deployment, you can use the icons on the left. So one dimension are groups where subnet is located, and another one is the state of the subnet. If we go back to the instance creation screen, we can see first that there are subnets that have managed instance icon next to it. This means that this subnet already contains managed instance and you can use it to add another one. If you see the subnet icon on the left, there can be two situations. One, this subnet is already prepared for instance deployment and it is colorized. And one that is without color, the gray one, which means that this subnet is empty and can be used for instance deployment, but it has to be prepared upfront. If you want, you can manually do this and then get back to the instance creation screen, or you can simply select it and the instance creation process will do all the job. Let's go back to the existing instance in the networking tab. We can see the smaller amount of subnets, and as I mentioned, we have to do manually these preparation jobs in order to use some subnet for instance move. And what does this mean? This means that we have to create or use some existing network security group and out table on our subnet. The instance that we observed is deployed in managed instance subnet. And this subnet has some managed GRL table assigned, and it is also delegated to the SQL managed instance service. These are prerequisites for subnet to be used for instance deployment. So the same thing we have to do for any new and empty subnet we want to use for instance, for moving instance to it. We have to create the route table and network security group assigned to it and delegate this subnet to the SQL managed instance. Now, this is a requirement if subnet is located inside the same virtual network. But what if the subnet is located in another virtual network and we want to go to that virtual network? In order for one instance to be moved from one virtual network to another, there is additional step that has to be done, and that is to create to establish a peering between the virtual network where instance is currently located and the virtual network where we want to move our instance. So this is our current virtual network, and we need to create a peering toward destination virtual network, but we also have to go to the destination virtual network and create the peering in opposite direction to our current virtual network. With this condition met, our virtual network in subnet that are not ready, for instance, move, will now be will be part of the group that that consists of subnets and virtual network available as a destination for our managed instance. All of this is explained in our public documentation, including instructions on how to prepare your virtual network and subnet. So for more details, visit the official docs, and if there is need at any point in time to move your managed instance to another virtual network or subnet, don't hesitate to do so. Thank you.